So let's talk about Chile.
Chile.
Chile. What? How do I say it?
You say Chile.
It's Chile?
Yes.
Not Chile?
Yes.
Got it.
All right. So the Buenos Aires Times had this really great article. As you guys know, Chileans overwhelmingly voted to scrap their Pinochet era constitution. And of course, Augusto Pinochet was an actual dictator who literally killed people who dissented.
Yeah.
And
9/11, 1973. That's what the first 9/11 was that one. Yeah.
And so they're going to draft a new constitution. More than half of the votes were counted. It was about 77.9 backing a fresh charter. And this was, of course, didn't happen overnight, you guys. They didn't just vote this into action. They have been protesting for the last 50 years, fighting against the remnants of the fascism. And they also were protesting last year. People took to the streets. So I'm going to go over that, a little bit of that. I wanted to kind of highlight a couple things in this article in particular. And that's just one of the pictures that we had of the streets in there in Chile. And you can see hundreds of thousands, if not maybe million people out there. So this vote, of course, came, like I said, a year after a million people took to the streets in downtown Santiago, which is the capital of Chile, amidst a wave of social unrest that left about 30 people dead and thousands wounded. This happened over a year ago, and it took millions of people there to say, you know what, we really want to draft a new constitution. The size of the October 25th march demonstrated the breadth of social discontent and proved a tipping point for the demonstrators' demands for a referendum. It was approved by 66% of voters in a 1980 plebiscite, but critics say many voters were cowed into acceptance this regime that had arrested, tortured, and killed thousands of suspected leftist opponents following the overthrow of an elected socialist government. So back in the day when this charter was approved, it was approved by 66% of the population, but the vast majority of the population was threatened to approve it. If you didn't approve it, you were exiled, killed, excommunicated. And that is the whole history of Augusto Pinochet, who literally committed so many atrocities in Chile and tried to expand his
government.
Exactly.
Backed by the United States government.
Backed by the U.S. government.
And killed the elected leader.
Yeah, and he had to, and he was trying to expand that throughout all of Latin America. And this just goes to show you, Pasta, like you just said, that the United States continuously has engaged in coups and regime changes in Latin America for decades. Yeah, for decades.
Yeah. I was having an argument with my friend the other day. He says, well, you know, we really don't know what they know and stuff. So sometimes we just got to take it for what it's worth because we're not in the war room with them. I'm like, that's an excuse. 9 times out of 10, it's about resource extraction or not allowing a socialist government for Americans to see just south of their border. Because if they're going to get free health care down there, you know, they're going to get better education. We're going to say, well, why don't we get that too? I don't know why we don't get that when we see Israel, who gets all this money from us with universal health care and higher education. We kick them all this cash and all this money that we don't say, well, why aren't we getting that too? You know what I'm saying? It's like, it's all over, ladies and gentlemen. But this is the situation. This was the first 9/11, 1973. Pinochet was just a brutal leader. And I'm glad we see this come to fruition right now. Millions of people in the streets, fam. It's hard to argue with you when you say when people get in the streets, change can't be done. It's they're showing this right now here in this country. So it's great.
And the new constitution would expand the role of the state in providing welfare.
I'm sorry. My bad.
Welfare, safety net, and it would be ensuring basic rights to health, education, water distribution, and pensions. So you see these things? These are socialist things. These are social
education,
safety nets.
Water.
These are what Chile is planning on doing for their people, backing them and providing for them. That is like where Latin America is at. So now we have Bolivia, we have Chile moving towards that area, and then we have Venezuela. So I don't know how long it's going to take, but it's not going to take very long
I
for us to
sanctions
be in there.
Right around the corner.
Yeah, we. I mean,
I smell sanctions right around the corner.
The leadership in Chile right now isn't a socialist leadership, but you can tell that the people were discontent. In the article, they were talking about the people not having enough money, a large income inequality, and so what did they do? They didn't just say, "Well, you know, we just got to vote for the other guy." They actually took to the streets. And that's my whole point in showing that and talking about this article, too, is a lot of neoliberals and some progressives were saying, well, you know, they voted for a new constitution. Look, Bolivia voted a fascist out. No, you guys, they have been fighting and fighting and fighting for a while, for decades. The Bolivians were fighting the last regime every single day in the streets. They were protesting. They were doing everything they could. This didn't just happen because they voted. Okay, they didn't just do that automatically. That doesn't happen. It takes direct actions. Yeah. Yeah. It takes protesting. Yeah. It takes all of that, yeah. And then you go vote in a system with fair elections. Yeah.
And the fact is that you have to back up these elections. You have to have everybody in place, and they did that. Yep. They had a whole year from when they threw Evo Morales out, almost not a whole year, but a while to get ready for this situation. They organized. They were there. They had all the securities in place. They had all their exit polls in place. They had all their people there, their watchers. They brought in observers left and right. So they got a free, fair election, and they got the guy out, and they got the person in who they wanted to get in. So if they can do it, we can do it. And I suspect Chile's going to do the same thing with their next leader in their next elections as well. So you have this AFP news agency up here.
Yeah, Johnny, it's just a video of the people, thousands
in Santiago.
Santiago. Celebrations.
There it is.
And then we have a I don't know where you're at. We have a video by Telesur. Should be the next one.
Yep. It's a lot of people.
Yeah, 100,000. The streets. I wanted to read what Maduro said, because Maduro said, "My congratulations, recognition, and admiration to the Chilean people who today turn into the streets and electoral centers to decide the future of their constitution and put an end to the Pinochet era. The great avenues are opened to build a better society. Long live Chile. Long live Allende."
I like what he says, the Pinochetism. How do you say it? That's perfect. Throw the ism on it, because that's what his culture was. You know what I'm saying? And you said that he wanted to spread this throughout the whole region too as well, right?
Yeah, so they said long live Allende. They're talking about Salvador Allende, which was the liberator of Chile. And Oli Vargas is a independent journalist who was just recently interviewed by the Gray Zone, but he's been doing great work in Bolivia. And basically, he had this video: yesterday Bolivia, today Chile, tomorrow Ecuador. It's possible for people's movements to win. Latin America has shown that numerous times in the past 20 years.
Next week, Peru.
Yeah, Latin America.
The week after, Peru.
No, they're corporate capitalists right now. So Latin America, I mean, is really showing us that that is possible. And that, honestly, if it gets any bigger than this, if these movements start expanding, the United States is definitely going to act. Do not be mistaken. So let's just look at a little bit of his footage.
I'm seeing a lot of Huawei advertisements in these Chile videos.
Interesting.
China.
And I wanted to give an update on Bolivia, because the three policies announced by Bolivia's president, Luis Arce, and this is Washington News, are new wealth and property tax, investigations into massacres of coup regime.
Ooh.
And restoring relations with Cuba, Venezuela, and Iran. That one itself is going to get, it's going to get them. Like,
Forget about it. They're going to be put on a list right now.
This is why I worry, especially because both the Trump administration and the Biden administration are going to be hawkish against these countries. It, honestly, either one of them. Either one of them. Because Trump's goons tried to push regime change in Venezuela. They failed, but they tried. They were extremely hostile towards Evo Morales. And so Biden has also said the same exact things. Remember when we played that trivia game when we were trying, it was hard to see who was the Democrat and the Republican and with the politicians for the Rock.
Yeah, totally.
So Biden has said similar things regarding Bolivia and Venezuela. He's called Maduro a brutal dictator, et cetera. So it worries me regardless of who's president
that we're going to coup the Congress. Yeah.
Yeah.
That was really scary. And, you know, you had Nancy Pelosi standing up quicker for anybody else for Juan Guaido. So they're united when it comes to regime change, definitely in Latin America.
And the last thing I wanted to note regarding Bolivia is the fact that Luis Arce is calling for
the OAS.
Yeah, the OAS Secretary General, Luis Amargo, and he wants his resignation, saying that he doesn't care for his congratulations.
Because what the OAS did was allow for that regime change to take place. Thousands of people were dead, were killed, or millions of people were pouring into the streets. So I'm glad he's going right to the source and say, this is the OAS. This is the guys who are trying to say they're overseeing elections. No, the guy is corrupt. He sat there. He did what he had to do. He needs to go. I love this right here. This is a great move.
So he said, I think things are clear. We agree there. There was no fraud. There was a whole preparation for a coup of which the OAS unfortunately was a part of. The president-elect told La Razón, adding that he didn't care about Almagro's congratulations on his victory in the presidential elections. He believes that Almagro's violated Bolivian regulations and those of any international body observing an electoral process. He interfered in internal affairs. So again, this is something that happened. This is the OAS was in on it. They were trying to frame it to say that Evo Morales was trying to cheat in this election so he could stay in power, trying to frame it as a brutal dictator, etc. Again, the same rhetoric. That wasn't the case. I see people use that argument all the time saying, well, I'm glad Bolivia is great now, but Evo Morales was trying to stay in power and blah, blah, blah. And it's like, you guys are spewing CIA talking points. You do not know what you're talking about. That is not what happened. Their elections were fine. Their elections are far better than ours, just like Venezuela's is. And so the fact is we didn't want Evo Morales there because we don't want an indigenous socialist president in Latin America who's giving people our people are being denied.
Yeah. And also the fact that they had the lithium. They had the contracts. The Chinese outbid us. So we were not going to let that happen. That's where coup came from. Our boy Elon Musk. Never buy a Tesla because he's an asshole. Maybe you want to. But the OAS. And I just picture Cory Booker. And then we'll go, well, I take my information from the OAS. And that's where I stand. Like, yeah, Corey, sure. Regime change aficionado. They all suck. Even when they kind of framed the question for Bernie Sanders, what's his name? Jorge Ramos, I believe it says.
Yeah.
Well, you know, should we allow Evo Morales to be a dictator? And, you know, Bernie said it was a coup, plain and simple.
Yeah.
Military got involved. Thank you for the Super Chat contribution from Kanoa Q, $9.99, I guess. That's a nice sticker. Thank you so much. That is very generous of you. Wallace West, what was the Chilean constitution like? The brick that was written by Chicago boys? Keep up the great work, fam. Meaning their old constitution that Pinochet wrote.
Yeah, it was
written but with American influence, with Western influence, because we helped them out and removed...
And they forced them to pass it, like I said.
Oh, yeah.